Alright, it's time for another Heavy Metal Gamer video blog, and today I want to talk about the Steam Deck, which is a new handheld console coming out from Valve. Now, it's apparently supposed to be shipping in December of 2021, which it'll be around the holiday season, and that's cool and all. But I'm just going to say this right now, the Intellivision Amico is going to be better, and that's it for this video. No, I'm just kidding. So, this was announced not too long ago, like almost a week ago, and I've been kind of critical of it, talking with friends, and I've been making some snide remarks on Facebook because I'm an asshole, but a lot of it's just being funny and ridiculous. So basically, people are saying it's going to be the Nintendo Switch killer. Now, I don't own a Nintendo Switch. I've played the console before, both the handheld side and on the TV and all that shit, because I have quite a few friends that own one already. Everybody's saying this is going to be the Nintendo Switch killer, and I don't think it will be. I think Nintendo is still going to do just fine. People are still going to buy the Switch for what? Exclusive games. People love to play Mario, either the platformer games. They like anything that's Nintendo exclusives, which is why I would like to have a Nintendo Switch so I could buy the exclusives. Now, of course, a lot of people are saying, well, you could play your PC games when you're at the bus stop and at the train station and at the airport and all that type of shit. You know, if I'm at those places, I'm going to be more worried about getting on the bus, getting a seat, getting on the train and all that type of shit. And of course, your flight. Maybe if you're on the bus and everything else, okay, I can understand that. But a lot of people are saying, well, it's like waiting in line to do this, this, and this. Or you could take it on the road with you if you're at a hotel. Now, me personally, I don't game when I'm at a hotel or if I'm camping or all that bullshit. I'm doing other things. I'm out having fun, staying away from gaming. But for those of you out there that want to do that type of stuff, okay, more power to you. You have the right to do that, and that's cool. There's nothing wrong with that. I'm not saying that's wrong. But let's kind of go through the specs already with this thing. And I'm scrolling through here on Steam. Actually, that's the wrong thing I'm looking for. PCGamer.com. Okay, so the CPU is an AMD Zen 2. Okay, that's pretty good. 4-core, 8-thread, 2.4, 3.5 gigahertz. The GPU is an AMD RDNA 2. Let's see, the clock speed's 1 to 1.6 gigahertz. 16 gigabytes of RAM, which is pretty good. I mean, that's what a laptop is usually running at, if not a little bit more. My gaming laptop, I think, has 16 gigabytes of RAM, so that's pretty fucking good. Now, there are three different price points for this thing because there's three different types of Steam Decks, and the storage on it is 64 gigabytes, 256 gigabytes, and 512 gigabytes. Now, here's the one that I kind of laugh at, and this goes for the Nintendo Switch too, the LCD touchscreen. Okay, the Nintendo Switch has a decent sized one, but this is going to be a 7-inch LCD touchscreen on the Steam Deck. Okay, so that's pretty good for your PC gaming, but do you really want to play Dark Souls on a 7-inch screen, or Grand Theft Auto, let's just say Roller Coaster Tycoon, or some sort of simulation game? I personally wouldn't. I think it would look like shit. But, once again, this is a handheld. You can play it when you're on the road and all that type of shit. It's what everybody likes to turn it back to, and I get that to a point, but I would rather play these games on a TV or a computer screen. Resolution's 1280 by 800. Once again, resolution is kind of a part of the graphics looking a little better, so the higher the resolution, the better the game's gonna look in that aspect. Obviously, there's other settings you're going to have to go through. If I'm running a game at 1280, but it can run at the highest settings, it's going to look fine, but it's not going to look amazing. Now, there's nothing wrong here with 1280 by 800 on a 7-inch screen. It's going to look fine. But once again, some of those games I have a feeling are going to be downgraded a bit. Refresh rate is 60 hertz. Audio stereo speakers, 3.5 millimeter jack, dual mics, USB type C, Bluetooth. Okay, that's typical. Connectivity, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, USB type C with DisplayPort, 1.4 support. Size is, it weighs about 1.47 pounds. So it's going to be very light. And the price points, we'll get to that here shortly. Now, some people say, well, it's a little bit bigger than the Switch. A bit. I think the standard version of the Nintendo Switch is 9.4 by 4 by 0.55, which would be obviously how thick the damn thing is. And it weighs just under a pound, but the Steam Deck is a couple inches wider, half an inch taller, and it's a bit thicker and obviously a little bit heavier, which is good. Battery life is going to be an issue with these things, just like with the Switch or any handheld. And it all depends on what kind of settings you use. The higher the settings on the graphics and everything, the more it's going to drain that battery. Let's talk about the price points. The 64 gigabyte Steam Deck is $399, so basically $400 with a little bit of tax, probably $415. Depends on where you're at. I think in my state it'll be about $410. I don't know exactly, but I'm not going to sit here and try to figure all that shit out for you. But it's $399. It comes with a carrying case, which is obviously something that it's going to need to come with. The 256 gigabyte version is $529. It comes with a carrying case, exclusive Steam Community Profile bundle, and faster storage. That's cool, I guess. The 512 gigabyte Steam Deck is $649. Faster storage, has an exclusive carrying case, exclusive Steam Community Profile bundle, exclusive virtual keyboard theme, and the premium anti-glare etched glass. Now, that's not bad. I mean, the price is a little steep, but hey, if you want something like that. But looking at the Steam Deck, it looks like it's going to handle pretty decent with the controls. I don't think there's going to be any issues there. But there's one thing that worries me a shitload and makes me very skeptical of the Steam Deck: Valve and their track record with hardware. I mean, even software. I mean, they haven't made any games in for fucking ever, other than they were involved with Half-Life Alyx, but they haven't made a Half-Life 3, they haven't made a Left 4 Dead 3. A lot of people want those games, including myself. But let's talk about their hardware. Steam controller. It had hardly any official support. It was very poor. It needed community guides to get it to run, and that's a damn shame. But then again, that controller looked fucking weird. I just don't know how that thing would have worked out. The Steam Link, it was barely advertised, and most people didn't know what it did or even that it existed. And then they sold them for dirt fucking cheap to get rid of their stock of it. The Steam Box, it was advertised as a console killer, but it was nothing more than an overpriced gaming PC. It also dropped because Valve didn't bother putting any effort into it. And that's a damn shame, because that could have been something good, but it was not a console killer. There's still consoles out there today. The only thing that has really taken off for Valve is the Vive, the VR headset. And even that, I mean, there was a glorified tech demo, and it was mainly supported by indie games and indie developers. And when it came to AAA titles, it was a cheap cash grab, which is not a horrible thing, but it's not a good thing. You would think they would have put a little bit more effort into it. At the end of the day, it was saved by good indie games that were made for it. And obviously, over the years, my thoughts of VR has definitely changed. If you remember, I did a video quite a few years back where I was very, very critical of it, and look where it is now. Is it as big as what some people think it's going to be? No. But is it big? Yes, it is. And it's a lot of fun. I definitely wouldn't mind getting a VR headset at a later time. Plus, I think it could be fun as hell, do a stream of it or a review or a let's play and be drunk as shit. I think that could be a lot of fun. So that's what really worries me about the Steam Deck. Will it get some support that it needs? Will it be gamer friendly and all that type of shit? And then some have said, well, it is a Switch killer because you can put a Switch emulator on there. Switch emulation isn't 100% right now, and it has a lot of issues, and it probably won't be like the Wii U until 3 or 4 more years. And by then, who knows if Nintendo's going to move on to the next console. I mean, maybe it's going to kill it when the Nintendo Switch is no longer relevant, 3-4 years down the line or even less. Because you know how Nintendo is with the development of consoles. They're a little bit behind, but they still make a shitload of money. And even in 3 or 4 years, there's still going to be some new things going with emulation. Look at PlayStation 3 emulation. There's some games that don't work. There's some games that do work. There's some games that have graphical issues. And it's still pretty good. And I'm pretty damn sure the Wii U emulation isn't 100% either. I don't know off the top of my head how many emulators are actually 100%. Maybe NES, Super Nintendo, Sega Genesis, obviously Atari and all the old computers. Sega Saturn isn't 100%. I don't know about Dreamcast. I think it's pretty damn close. PlayStation is pretty damn close. PlayStation 2 is pretty damn close. There are some games that still don't work or have some sort of issue. The GameCube is probably really close. Nintendo 64 is horrible. I mean, some games are better than others, but in the long run, Nintendo 64 emulation is not very good. The Wii, I've never really messed with it at this point. Just a few things here and there, but it seemed pretty damn good. So yeah, you could take the gamble and go Switch emulation, but there's also the gamble where it's not going to work. And I see a lot of people bringing that up. Oh, I'll just put a Switch emulator on it. Yeah, well, I mean, more power to you. Good luck. It's not going to be 100%. Just to end my thoughts on this, I'm not saying the Steam Deck is a bad thing. I think it's a pretty good thing. but it's not going to be the Switch killer. It's not going to kill off Nintendo. And I'm very skeptical of how Valve is going to handle this hardware. If they do a damn good job with it, then awesome. There's going to be a lot of happy people out there. Will I purchase one? Probably not. But there are many people that are very excited for it, and there's nothing wrong with that at all. And I'm not doing this video to kill your excitement. I just think people need to be very skeptical of what's going on with this thing and if it's going to have the support and all that type of shit. And like I said, there's a lot of good points here. I think tech-wise, with all the specs, it's really good. But there's some other things that I'm worried about. Anyways, what is your thoughts on the Steam Deck? Are you going to purchase one? Have you already purchased one? Are you excited for it? Are you not excited for it? Are you skeptical like me? Are you worried about it? Talk about it in the comments below. I hope you enjoyed this Heavy Metal Gamer video blog. Thank you for watching, and you motherfuckers, kick ass.